sit there, you ask yourself, what's great about this act? What is great about them? Why do so many people like them? What is it that connects with the public? And then if you can find that in your head, sometimes it takes a week, sometimes it takes a month in your head to find that out in your own mind, and then you just major on that.
Video Killed the Radio Star presents Extended Play, The Artist's View. In this episode, Queen's Roger Taylor, directors David Mallet and Russell Mulcahy discuss the creative process behind Queen's legendary music videos.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality.
Bohemian Rhapsody was the first music video that people noticed as a music video, without a doubt.
I'm just a poor boy. I need no sympathy. Because I'm easy come, easy.
Really, it was an easy way out for us. It was a way that we could get on Top of the Pops without actually having to go there, because we've just started our tour. And we were actually playing the Liverpool Empire, I think, or something like that.
To me, Baba.
And we were sort of allied to this outside broadcast unit, which actually filmed sporting events for ITV. So we thought, why don't we just get them into Elstree, where we were rehearsing, and film it. So we got a hold of a sort of director and filmed it in 4 hours, and then we got in the bus and went to Liverpool. I think we did very quickly realise the power of the video then, because it was on Top of the Pops week after week after week. And we'd be sitting in a bus somewhere, watching it and thinking, blimey, this is good, we don't even have to go there, you know, because that was a very boring day at Top of the Pops.
The sort of bog-standard music video thing of guitar solo and then you see the guitar and drum fill and you see the drum fill, we all rather went against that. I think the first time we deliberately went against that was with Queen, with Radio Gaga, when I think we said we would do a whole video with not a drum kit or a guitar in sight. And even Brian May agreed to that. The idea for using bits of Metropolis was Freddie. I then said, great to use it, but we've got to integrate you lot with it somehow. So we built that funny car and then flying through the air and used the wide shots from Metropolis and then cut in to see the band and the car and all that.
I'd sit alone and watch your light, my only friend through teenage night. Is everything I had to know?
Like all the best videos that certainly I've ever made, the ideas come 50-50 from me and the stars. Sometimes 100% from the stars, sometimes whichever, but the best stuff is always the collaboration,
yeah.
Isn't it?
You made us feel like we could fly.
So don't we cut some background noise. All I was trying to do was find some way of fitting Metropolis into a different setting, and I thought if we make the whole video period, wartime for instance, or semi-wartime, it would tie it all together, and it did.
Sort of nostalgic.
Yeah, yeah.
You've yet to have your finest hour. Radio.
The hand clapping bit just struck me as being incredibly obvious at the time. The choreography kind of felt like the music.
Radio Gaga.
we hear is... Queen has a huge fan club. It was no problem getting 1,000 fans and dress them up in paper suits and spray them with a spray gun because they were going to be in the video. The other thing about fans that I find extraordinary was that when they arrived in the film studio that day, they'd never heard Radio Gaga because it hadn't been released. And yet they were note perfect or choreography perfect a couple of hours later when we came to film it. All
we hear is Radio Gaga. We were used to criticism. I don't know if David was.
I mean, basically, whatever video you make, someone will take that video, turn it round in their head and write something that is basically something that none of us ever thought of.
Yeah.
Whatever. It's not just that video. Every single video I've ever made, someone reinterprets it.
As for the sort of reference to Nazis, that section was meant to sort of portray the mind control of the workers in the movie Metropolis.
So, mind-numbing.
Yeah, yeah.
It didn't have any bearing on Nazi rallies at all that
no,
I could think of.
No,
it still doesn't.
No. There's always a huge amount of people that just don't get things.
Or get it wrong.
Yeah.
I said Freddie had to be the lady with all the neon things going up and down, which again everybody had a heart attack about except Freddie. Whereas some people who are out front only want the camera on them, Freddie was completely different. He wanted the focus to be on the band and not Freddie, which is surprising for someone of his performing ability.
Freddie was the singer, you know, and the singer's meant to be the guy that puts it over, probably more than any other person, because he's doing the singing, he's delivering the lyric and the melody, but we were a democracy.
The whole band was at one stylistically all the time. If one of them wanted to do Metropolis, they all did. If one of them wanted to, for them all to appear in drag, they all did. Frankly, we were stuck for ideas for Break Free. We just couldn't get it worked out, and Roger arrived late, having been stuck in traffic, to this meeting. And Roger walked straight in and said, "I know what we've got to do. The Stones have done it. Now we're going to do it. We're going to do it in drag." And at that minute, the scales fell from my eyes, and I saw this little 1950s house, and Brian May being woken up by a tease maid, and John being a grumpy granny, and Roger being a naughty schoolgirl, etc., etc. And then I thought, what character to make Fred? And I thought Liverpudlian slag is the answer.
I want to break free. I want to break free. I want to break free from your lies. You're so self-satisfied, I don't need you.
Then Fred got all tiddly-pom about what he's going to wear and how short the skirt should be. And then he said, "Of course, I'm going to shave off my moustache, darling." And I said, "No, the one thing you mustn't do, the funny thing is that your moustache is there and you're in drag." And to this day, when he comes around the corner with that Hoover, to this day I laugh.
God knows. God knows I want to break free. I've fallen in love. I've fallen in love for the first time. And this time.
The most fun of any video we ever made.
I laughed for 3 days straight making that, and at the end of the 3 days, my ribs were hurting because I'd been laughing non-stop. We all were. We were hysterical.
Yeah, it was just one long laugh, actually.
Oh, how I want to be free. Oh, how I want to break free.
But of course, then there's the middle section, which is quite funny, where he insisted on getting the whole of the Royal Ballet.
Oh, Royal Ballet.
For which he did shave his moustache off. It was a joint thing, but David would have the last word because he was the sort of boss on set, you know.
But I think it's very important to say that we had discussed virtually everything that we were going to do first. Mm. I never, ever surprised them with anything. And as a result of never, ever surprising them with anything, the situation never arose when they said, no, we don't want to do that, because we'd discussed it all before.
You have to trust the director, really, and then it's his fault if you look daft.
But life still goes on. I can't get used to
living. As a measure of sort of thinking at MTV, that they thought it was disgraceful and didn't show it and banned it.
God knows. Got to make it my own.
The thing, the drag thing, is just funny. I don't see it as shocking in any way. That's a bit more rock and roll, really, than growing your hair and wearing spandex and poncing about. And, you know, it's a bit more daring, isn't it? We don't really care, you know. Difficult to come up with something that people haven't done. So much got done so quickly, you know. And then you'd sort of go back to the live sort of shoot or pseudo live shoot or whatever. It became quite a chore, actually.
Radio Gaga and Break Free and Under Pressure were probably the first videos that Queen had done that weren't straight performance things in a garden or wherever, apart from Bohemian Rhapsody, which was a straight performance but with added wonderful bits.
It was actually shot in a real tour on our stage in Brussels.
And then we filmed in the afternoon, some bits, and then we filmed a sort of live thing in the evening in front of the audience. I think at that point we thought, enough conceptualisation, let's do some good hard rock and roll again. Also, we hadn't got any bloody time, had we?
Because we hadn't got any time. We had a great lighting rig, you know, which looked great.
In those days, that touring look was only really familiar to people that went to see tours. Yeah. 99% of the population had never been to a rock tour or a rock music venue, particularly a big one like that. In fact, Queen in those days were probably only one of two that had big lighting rigs and big tours and big...
One of a few.
Arena things,
yeah,
very few.
Yeah,
yeah. It was a rarity. So
more lights than the Vatican.
Yes.
Waiting for a hammer.
It's a kind of magic. It's a kind of magic. A kind of magic. One dream, one soul, one prize, one gold, one golden glance of what should be. It's a kind of magic. One shaft of light that shows the way.
I always wanted to make feature films, and when I made videos, I didn't consider myself a filmmaker, in a way, you know? Not a serious filmmaker.
A Kind of Magic came out of the movie, really. We met Russell through David, and Russell was part of this stable of four directors. And then Russell was making this big budget movie, and he said, do you want to come over to see The Rushes and you know, see what we've put together so far? And it was very incomplete. And we thought it looked magnificent. And so then we said, yeah, well, we'd like to be involved. And so we wrote a lot of the soundtrack.
I never had a script. Like my storyboards were like, you know, little boxes with scribbles on it, and you would, you know, I would defy anyone to understand what they were, but I could completely see what that squiggle was. And I think storyboards should be like that.
I think Russell was very creative. I think the visual was everything for him. A great idea is the main thing.
For the videos, it's more squiggles, ideas, concepts. I mean, I knew there were going to be three figures. Our friend became a very dear friend. God bless his soul. Yeah. I told, you know, obviously, I said, you know, it's going to be like extremely like animated. You know. And I think I probably showed him a bit of Mary Poppins or something. He said, I'm dying, I've seen that. And so he got the concept. The only thing that was hard for convince Freddie to do was to sing New York, New York for Highlander. Eventually he did it, but it took a bit of convincing.
We shot it in the Playhouse Theatre, I remember. We wanted this sort of theatrical thing. I think we were sort of tramps. And we magically, the magic came into the room and it was sort of fairly early special effects, you know, and magical things happened, and it was nicely shot, actually. It was nicely done. Basically, we were acting to nothing. Acting, say acting, you know. Musicians don't make very good actors, in my experience.
Say that during the era of Gaga and Break Free and those sort of records, You didn't really say, have you heard the new Queen record, as much as you said, have you seen the new Queen record?
Yeah, yeah.
And people regularly used to refer to a new record as, have you seen it? Because it was a new art form, it was fresh, people kind of saw records more than, or as much as listening to them. We were very disciplined. We organised everything, but we certainly didn't write it out. What a dreadful, boring thing to do. No way. We knew what we were going to do, and I wrote it on the back of a fag packet, and it was in my back pocket. And that's really as far as it got.
He got on his crane, and he'd sit out there like Ozymandias and issue writs.
From on high.
From on high, yeah.
Like a crown, pretend that you're still around. Yeah. Ooh. To me, when I feel what my heart can conceive.
It was a sort of monster that the video. Genre, wasn't it? And but David seemed to be making the most intelligent videos around. Just like a girl, like a clown. Doing those videos, I mean, David sort of became the sort of fifth member, a very bossy fifth member.
Thank you.